Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, what's new in ProPresenter 7.15? Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've been excited about a new version of ProPresenter, go ahead, subscribe, leave a comment, thumbs up, you know, all that fun jazz. So Renewed Vision has done it again for the 15th time since January of 2020. They've released a major version of ProPresenter. And this one has a ton of new features. Some of them seem minor maybe, but if you run into the situation, you'll be glad that you've renewed your ProPresenter Plus and can use these features. So let's head over to the computer and we will talk about that. So here I am in the beta of ProPresenter 7.15. I'm actually recording this before it was even announced. I'm not going to release it till it is announced, but I am recording this a little bit early, so you might notice the date up there. Yeah, I've been playing with it. So let's go through some of the different features. We've got ProContent search. So if I bring that down, we've got that. One big one that people are going to be really excited to see, if I go into looks and then edit looks, right here we have transitions. Now it's only a dissolve transition, but notice that it changes on every single one. So I can have a dissolve between some looks and not others. And so that's a kind of cool feature as well, that when I change looks, it will dissolve from one look to another, which a lot of people have been clamoring for quite some time. Video delay. So if we go up here to ProPresenter and settings, if you're on Sonoma, which by the way, ProPresenter 7.15 supports Sonoma, so that's another thing. If you're on Sonoma or Ventura, it'll say settings. On other OS's, including Windows, it'll say preferences. If we go down from settings to inputs, so you might think that you add the video delay in here on any of the video sources, but it's not on the video source end. It's actually on the video output end of things. So what we're going to do is close this, and this gives me a chance to show you another new feature, which is the test patterns. So we will go to view, test patterns, and I've already switched to the audio video sync test pattern, which is one of the new ones. We've also got a logo bounce, a radar, solid color, just a few that weren't here before, lines. If you want to see some about the blend grid, color bars, etc., I've got another tutorial about those, but I will talk a little bit about those new ones in specific here. And notice down here I can do either the audio delay to each of the audio outputs, or I could do video delay to any of my screens that I'm sending video out to. So that is another helpful thing. Notice I've got this set to 8 frames on that. So cool thing going on there.
Hey there, aspiring ProPresenter Pro. Are you tired of getting tangled up in tech trouble? Want to impress your congregation with mind-blowing visuals? Well, look no further. Introducing ProPresenter 7 training at Church Tech U, your secret weapon for unlocking ProPresenter's full potential. Join me as I dive into the world of captivating presentations, smooth transitions, and jaw-dropping effects. From beginner basics to advanced tips and tricks, I've got you covered. Don't miss out on this amazing opportunity. Visit churchtechu.com/free trial for a free month now. Did I mention it's free? And revolutionize your ProPresenter game. Your congregation will thank you.
So that's the enhanced test patterns, improved in-app support. If we go up here, notice that I can report an issue or submit feedback here. So if I'm running into a problem, I can just directly from ProPresenter click on report an issue, give my email, my full name, talk about how everything is, and then it will gather the appropriate stuff and then send it right from here. And I can add additional attachments if I want to. So that's a cool little feature, especially if you've ever been in a situation where, oh, I need to report this problem right now. You can drop them a line, support@renewedvision.com, but now you don't have to anymore. You can just go ahead and do that from the help screen as well. I mentioned support for macOS Sonoma, macOS 14, so that's cool here. The stage screen, now I'm going to hide myself for this. So over here we go to this icon, which is the stage screen, and before there wasn't this little plus button here. So what that enables you to do is you can add a new stage screen right here from Show Controls. So you click here and you can just basically do everything that you can do in the configure screens, or just go directly to configure screens if you need to do something there as well. That's a pretty cool thing. One thing that existed before is you could edit layouts from here. I just didn't know about it because there is so much to learn about in ProPresenter, so much to know that it's easy to not catch it all. So that's something else that you can do. And finally, they have also added a refreshed first start screen. So when you first start up ProPresenter, before you've added any of your own files or anything, that looks different. I, of course, have added many, many, many files and reset it and done all kinds of stuff. So I'm not going to show that to you right now, maybe in one of the subsequent tutorials that I do, diving more deeply into each of these new features. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/pro, the number 7 and quick. Give me your name and email address and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.